Editor for the Washington Examiner, Mark Tapscott, is with me, along with Dave Weigel, an MSNBC contributor and a Slate political reporter. So, Dave, can Huntsman actually win points with this strategy?
Well, he can win points with the media, which seem right now to be his constituency. With the Republican electorate, it's not quite as clear how this gives him an advantage. The theory of the Huntsman campaign is that there are going to be some open primaries where he can get an advantage because Democrats, independents, who don't really have a race in 2012, will come in and vote for him. But the pollsters have been asking that, and the math has not been adding up. I mean, the critique he's making of the Republican Party is just not backed up by a lot of credibility as coming from somebody who worked for the Obama administration, who is a rising star governor, but not really a high-profile governor. No, I mean, he's carving out a niche for officers more than some candidates are doing, but I don't think incredibly effectively.
Yeah, and I wonder, Mark, especially in this political climate, and we've already seen how much influence the Tea Party can have, can a moderate win the Republican nomination?
Well, I don't think a hypocritical moderate like John Huntsman can win it. On May 16th, he, absolutely promised that he was going to only have a positive campaign and he was not going to go negative like everybody else was. Here, it's barely 2 months later and he's going negative against Perry, Rick Perry, everybody. No, it's not going to be John Huntsman, that's for sure.
So does that leave an opening then for Mitt Romney?
I'm not so sure that Mitt Romney qualifies as a moderate or conservative because we're not really sure which he is in some respects. I think there is always this theme in presidential election years among journalists that it's somehow a choice between a so-called far-right conservative and a moderate, and that doesn't reflect the makeup of the Republican Party.